Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Welcome to our celebration of the resurrection on this Easter Sunday morning at St. Francis in the Wood. For those of you who don't know, my name is Angus Stewart. I'm the rector here at St. Francis.
And I'm Alicia Greenfield.
As we begin our celebration, we kindle the Easter fire and light the Paschal candle, the Christ candle, to represent the living Christ, the risen Christ, among us.
Let us pray. Holy God, we share in the light of your glory through your Son, the light of the world. Sanctify this new fire and inflame us with new hope. Purify our minds by this Easter celebration and bring us one day to the feast of eternal light. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Let us keep a moment of silence.
We pray together the collect of the day. Lord of life and power, through the mighty resurrection of your Son, you have overcome the old order of sin and death, and have made all things new in him. May we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, reign with him in glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit is alive, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Wherever you may be.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you were looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen, as he had said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell the disciples, 'He has been risen from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you.'" So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to see his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him and took hold of his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." This is the Gospel of Christ.
What is this thing that has happened to us? It's a virus, yes. In and of itself, it holds no moral brief, but it is definitely more than a virus. Words from Arundhati Roy in the Financial Times this week, author of the Booker Prize winner, The God of Small Things, and her latest book, The Ministry of Utmost Happiness. She continues, "Some believe it's God's way of bringing us to our senses. Others that it's a Chinese conspiracy to take over the world. Whatever it is," she says, "coronavirus has made the mighty kneel and brought the world to a halt like nothing else could." She says, "Our minds are still racing back and forth, longing for a return to normality, trying to stitch our future to our past and refusing to acknowledge the rupture. But the rupture exists. And in the midst of this terrible despair, it offers us a chance to rethink the doomsday machine we have built for ourselves. Nothing could be worse than a return to normality. Offers us a chance to rethink the doomsday machine we have built for ourselves. Nothing could be worse than a return to normality. She continues, "Historically, pandemics have forced humans to break with the past and imagine their world anew. This one is no different. It is a portal, a gateway between one world and the next." A portal, a gateway between one world and the next. Arundhati Roy concludes, "We can choose to walk through it, dragging the carcasses of our prejudice and hatred, our avarice, our data banks and dead ideas, our dead rivers and smoky skies behind us, or we can walk through it lightly, with little luggage, ready to imagine another world, and ready to fight for it." As we come once more to think about and celebrate resurrection in this most unusual time, I am captured by Arundhati Roy's image of the portal, a gateway between one world and the next. Surely that is what is in our mind when we think of resurrection. Resurrection is a portal, a door, a gateway to a new world and a new life that we cannot begin to imagine. At least we cannot begin to imagine it in terms of a future life beyond the grave, just as perhaps we find it difficult to imagine how life will be once the coronavirus has passed. What will have changed? What will remain the same? The thought that the world might simply revert to how it was before seems to me dispiriting and disappointing. Surely we can do better than that. It would seem that we have been through all this for nothing if we cannot do better. Rather than simply longing for a return to normal, perhaps we need to take this time to ask ourselves what aspects of normal we would want to return to. A chance to rethink the doomsday machine we have built for ourselves. The question that is on my mind is, can we do this? Is humanity capable of changing for the better? Not simply changing the way we experience life, the way we consume life, but somehow changing deep down. One thing the virus has shown us is how connected we are, such that protecting oneself and protecting one's neighbour and even one's enemy become one and the same thing. Could this seed, could this germ of an idea grow and take root in the heart of humanity? Imagine that. Could it become as contagious as the coronavirus? Seeing clearly that the welfare of another, whether that is my neighbour or a refugee on the other side of the world who I have yet to meet, whether their welfare is as important as my own welfare and that of my family, my community, my country. Whatever I have believed about the resurrection, and however we understand the resurrection, it only really has relevance for us, only means anything, if we can experience it in our lives now. If we can perceive the first glimmer of resurrection light and allow it to transform who we are and how we live our lives. This is the resurrection of Jesus. Today, we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. But it is also our resurrection. It is the resurrection of Jesus who washed the feet of his disciples to give them a pattern of how to relate to one another. This is the resurrection of Jesus who said, "Love one another as I have loved you." This is the resurrection of Jesus who is the way, the truth, and the life. The Jesus who is the true vine in whom we must abide as he abides in us. This is the Jesus who prayed that his disciples and those who believe in him through their word would become one as he and the Father are one. If the coronavirus has taught us anything, it is that we are one, much more than we know, much more than we can imagine, much more than we have realized. And we return once more to the realization that we are not totally separate, discrete individuals, but we are part of one living whole organism. Our health and our welfare is bound up with one another. We are one. The resurrection of Christ is the resurrection of humanity, a portal to a new world, nothing less. Alleluia. Christ has risen. Christ has risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let us take a moment to prepare ourselves for prayer by being aware of our breath. To breathe deeply this breath that we all share, the breath of life, the breath of God. I invite us to be present with the prayer spoken aloud and the prayers we hold in our hearts, minds, and bodies. Source of all love and all life, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, thank you for being resurrected, for showing us that death can be an opening to new life, not only for the one who dies, but for all who are impacted by death. Thank you for changing the world and inviting us to participate. In these uncertain times of a COVID-19 virus, guide us to live our lives in ways that enable your love to be visible in social, political, medical, and financial structures of our world. Help us to see the new life you are opening our world up to. source of all love and all life, hear our prayer. Gentle healer, many are suffering. We all know people whose lives have taken a tragic turn, leaving them full of anguish and fear because of life's circumstances, in particular COVID-19. We pray for all people who are in the midst of losing the life they have come to know and to love. We pray for those whose homes are filled with unrest and are not safe, and for those who have no homes. We pray for all who are suffering because of the loss of physical contact and the loss of financial security. We pray for relationships that are challenged and for those who are ill and dying. Be with all who are in anguish. Surround them with your compassion and love, and fill them with your healing energy. Help them turn from their fear of loss and the unknown to your love. Give them courage to believe that all is well in these changing times. Give us faith in resurrection. There are those we know who are in particular need of your healing. We pray for Paul Saffron Jr., Angus Simpson, John Galvani, David Cox, Derek Leeson, Glenn Brand, Martha Nwaneri, Patrick Duffy, Jenny Evans, Glenn Dodd, Bob Harold, Ralph Carter, and for others we name aloud or in the silence of our hearts. Source of all love and all life, hear our prayer. Compassionate Spirit, we pray for those who have recently died. Joan Mann, Howard Windsor Martin, Norman Albin, and for others we name aloud or in the silence of our hearts. We pray for their families and friends that they may be aware of your comforting presence. Source of all love and all life, hear our prayer. Creator God, our Lenten appeal this year is to raise funds to sponsor a young woman, Nasri, and her young children for 1 year. They are coming from Kenya via Uganda. We pray for the safety and health of Nasri and her family as they wait. We pray that funds will be available to support them to come to Vancouver when the time is right. Source of all love and all life, hear our prayer. Holy One, we pray for members of our parish family. We give thanks for their contributions to parish life and pray for their relationship with you. Ian Beryl Finley, Jasper Follows, Robert and Nicola Follows, and Brenda Foster. Source of all love and all life, hear our prayer. Jesus, our teacher, thank you for helping us to learn new skills so we are able to continue our worship via the internet and reach many people who find comfort and peace from you through the services offered. We welcome and pray for those who are new to our community and give thanks for their participation and presence. We pray for our priest, Angus, and for our curate, Alicia. We give thanks for all they offer us through prayer, service, and teachings. source of all love and all life, hear our prayer. God, thank you for being with us this Easter season, as new ways of being and doing are revealed. We are one in you. Fill us with your love, full of compassion for all. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we rejoice to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. With us on a Sunday morning, please join us at 11 for a coffee on Zoom. This Wednesday, we will be having our 11 o'clock Bible study. And we say, Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.
Now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, that great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest upon you and remain with you always. Amen. And so, let us go out into the world in peace, rejoicing in our new life in the resurrection. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.